Hello and welcome to the last monthly Warriors HQ of the summer, ahead of the new season kicking off.
Coming up on this month's show, we catch up with Henry Pyrgos on captaining Scotland in Japan, the players return to pre-season training, and we get a sneak preview of our new Macron home and alternate kit for the new season.
In June, Scotland were touring Japan, with Henry Pyrgos captaining the side in the second test. With him back now at Warriors for pre-season training, we caught up with him to find out how he enjoyed the experience. Joined by Henry Pyrgos. Henry, the last time we saw you, you were captaining Scotland in Japan. That must have been an incredible honour for you.
Yeah, it was a great experience. I've been lucky enough to do it a couple of times now. So anytime you can get that opportunity to play for Scotland and obviously captain Scotland, it's amazing. It was great. Obviously, we went over there and won two games. End of a long, hard season, but it was going to be finished off like that. So now I'm back at Glasgow. I'm looking forward to that.
As you've said, you've captained Scotland a few times and you also captained us here at Glasgow. How does that sort of alter your game when you have to be the leader on the field?
I suppose the obvious thing is you've got to make decisions about the kick at post, things like that, kick to the corner. So those are things you probably think about a bit more before the game. You probably plan out, speak to the coaches, speak to other guys about how we're going to go forward and things like that. And then obviously through the week, you're trying to drive team goals, team messages, maybe focusing a bit more on the team than just yourself. So that's probably the major differences, I'd say.
As you've been captain like a number of times, have you looked to sort of change things and try new things, speak to different people, things like that?
I don't try to change things too much. I think you always try and develop, like, as the same as your game, really. You're trying to always improve where you can. You speak to experienced guys who've done it before, guys you respect around you, things like that. So you're always looking to improve and looking to add things, yeah.
As you said, we won both games in Japan. What was the tour like as a whole? Did you learn much? And what was it like being over there and playing in a different country?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, I was fortunate enough. I played there about 7 years ago now with the under-20s, so it was great to go back. Obviously with the full team. It is extremely hot at that time of year. It's obviously not the same over here, so that was something that was very different. A bit of a shock trying to play in those conditions. I think that bodes well for, hopefully if guys are involved in the World Cup in a couple of years' time going back there. But it was great to be in Japan. Obviously very different as well culturally. Tokyo is a bit crazy. Lots going on. Lots of people. Big buildings. Everything like that. So it was a good experience. Really enjoyed it.
And after you sort of finished the Glasgow season, you went straight into it with Scotland. How did you find that physically?
It was okay for me. I mean, I've been a slightly different season for me. I was out for a while, 4 months, I think, with a wrist injury. So I wasn't maybe as tired as some of the guys. So I was, just keen to carry on with the rugby, and any chance you get with Scotland is huge. So I was really looking forward to it. And as I said, it was great that we won two games.
The last time you were in a Glasgow shirt, it was obviously a disappointment for the Warriors, a loss in Connacht against the eventual champions. Have you had time to sort of look back and maybe watch that game, or is it not something you thought too much about?
I watched it back straight away, to be honest. It's it was a hugely disappointing day. I know, I think it's something we've spoken about as a group, when we came in after the game, things like that, and it's something that would definitely drive us going forward. Obviously, the year before we won the league, and last season we came up short in the semi-final. So we'll be using that as a driver and motivation to do better this season. Obviously, with Connor up first, it's an exciting start to the season. So it gives us something to look forward to.
And the Warriors have got a week down in England coming up. It's not that far away. First up's Harlequins away, and then Gloucester. Two sort of exciting games. Is that a challenge that you're looking forward to?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, you always want to play, top teams in pre-season to see where you're at, and that's great that we're playing Harlequins and Gloucester. A few familiar faces in those teams will play, which will be cool. So it'll be exciting. We've got a camp, as you said, down there, I think. So it'll be good again to spend a bit more time with the boys and get closer as a group. And it's a great test for us before the season starts.
I know you've just started, but how are the sort of new guys settling? You must be looking forward to coming up and against them in training, having lost quite a number of sort of good players last season. It was good to sort of welcome some new boys in.
Yeah, it's always the way with professional sport. There's always guys coming and going. So it's, they've been, traditions we have here with new guys, they've been saying hello, things like that, and getting a bit of stick. So it's great to get to know them, and hopefully that'll continue. We'll get to know them better, and they'll become key parts of the team. There's obviously some really experienced guys in there, like Corey Flynn and some less experienced guys, but I'm sure everyone will add their thing, and hope us can make the team better.
And I just don't.
you gain skills that you can take on to other aspects of your life. See, I got a wild heart and I can control it. It keeps on letting me down. I'm up with you tonight. Tell me why you like playing rugby.
I like scoring tries and working as a team. I'm scared to death.
Had to be mixed in with the boys and that wasn't very enjoyable, wouldn't really pass you and things like that. So it's good to have camps for girls. I would definitely come along if I was younger.
Would you give rugby a thumbs up or a thumbs down?
With the summer international tests over, the players are back for block two of pre-season. We've been down to see what they've been up to. During the summer, the Warriors have been recruiting, with Namibian Tjiuee Uanivi the latest player to sign on. So we spoke to him exclusively to find out more. So welcome to Glasgow Warriors. When it was announced that you were signing here, everyone was very excited. But one thing that the fans were wondering was how to pronounce your name. So how do you say your name?
Two ways to pronounce it. Okay, first one, Tjiuee. Tjiuee, that's what everyone calls me. And then everyone also calls me Tjiuee, so I don't mind.
And your second name?
Uanivi.
So tell us about how your move to Glasgow Warriors came about.
I was looking for options, and as soon as I heard that Glasgow Warriors were interested, I was up for it, and I was really excited to come here.
And so did you speak to Gregor Townsend? What was his sort of message to you?
Yeah, I spoke to him, and he told me about the philosophy of rugby here, which was also another thing I was looking forward to, and that's one of the convincing factors. And he basically told me that if I work hard enough and put in the right commitment, I could get game time. And basically, that's what he said.
And you've obviously arrived here in Glasgow at Scotstoun. What do you make of the stadium and the facilities as a whole?
Great facilities. I think it's a really nice setup for you, for any player to grow in and to work in. And the setup is. It's world class, I think.
With the new season looming, it's that time of year again where our new Macron home and alternate kits will be launched. Here's a teaser to whet your appetite. Thanks for watching this month's episode. We'll be back in August ahead of our first pre-season game against Harlequins on the 20th of August.